Hello again, everybody. I'm John Riddle, and today we've got a special treat for you, a tutorial on Krita and what's new for 2025. Now, in just a few minutes, we're going to show you how to use this tool. It's great for creating drawings and illustrations. You can use it with Windows, macOS, and Linux. It's a great alternative to Adobe Photoshop, and we're going to show you how to use it right now. When launching Krita, you open the welcome screen where you access your recent files or browse for others with Open Image. To start with a new project, go to New Image and choose any template on the left or select Custom Document Dimensions to set your own canvas dimensions, orientation, size, and resolution. Switch to Content to choose the background color or add any transparency, which is displayed as a checkerboard area. As you click on Create, the new document opens on the main workspace, showing a large canvas where you draw and work. On Settings, Dockers, you can hide or show several panels around the canvas according to your needs. You can also change the overall theme color from Settings, Themes, or the entire workspace type from the top right corner. In this tutorial, we will use the default workspace. Go to File, Open, to browse and import any image. This image and the new document have a separated tab at the top to choose which of the two must be shown on the canvas. You can zoom in and out using the mouse wheel while holding down the Control or Command key and pan by holding the space bar key. You can also enable rulers from Settings, Dockers, Grid, and Guides. To crop any document or image, enable the Crop tool and click and drag on the canvas to drop a grid, which saves the content within it. Drag the grid to move it or use its nodes to resize it. To apply the crop, right-click on the canvas and go to Crop. Every Krita document is made of several objects called layers listed under the Layers panel on the right. The new document comes with a background layer representing your canvas and a paint layer where all your future drawings will be collected. To start drawing, select the paint layer and enable any brush tool from the toolbox on the left side. You can drop lines, rectangles, and ellipses by clicking and dragging on the canvas. Enable the polyline tool and draw a polygon by dropping each vertex on the canvas and closing the shape. You can also drop an open shape by double-clicking on the last vertex. Enable the freehand brush tool to draw freehand as you like. Choose dynamic brush tool to draw smoother and flowing strokes. You can also use the multi-brush tool to mirror your drawing around the center of your document. To undo any action, remember to use Control or Command and Z. To change the brush color, click on Foreground Color Selector at the top and hold down Control to pick any color directly from the canvas. You can also adjust several brush properties, such as blending mode, opacity and size or stroke width, and enable the mirror tool to drop symmetric brushes. You can pick any predefined brush style from brush presets or by right-clicking anywhere on the canvas. For more detailed brush options, open the Tools Options panel in the top right corner. Now let's see how to draw vectors. Unlike pixel-based brushes, vectors are defined by mathematical algorithms, so they never lose quality regardless of scaling or transformations. First of all, create a new vector layer and select it to start drawing on it with any of the brush tools already seen. The drawings you drop on this layer will be automatically converted into vectors. Some tools, like the freehand brush tool, may not work on vector layers. To draw vectors freehand, enable the freehand path tool or the calligraphy tool instead. To add text, enable the SVG text tool and click and type text in the new dialog, where you can also set the font family, style, size, color, and alignment. To manage your vector shapes, enable the Select Shapes tool and click on any drawing to select it. Drag it to move it and use its nodes to resize or rotate it. Head to Tool Options to change Stroke Color, Stroke Thickness, and Fill Color. To refine the shape, enable the Edit Shapes tool and drag the nodes and handles on the drawing. Double-clicking on the shape path to add further nodes for additional customization. Brushes and vectors are listed under the Layer panel on the right. Here, click on the Eye icon to hide or show any layer, the Lock button to block any modification, and right-click on any layer to copy, paste, or remove it. Adjust the order of visibility by clicking and dragging a layer to a different position in the list, and right-click on any layer and go to Layer Style to apply effects such as shadows or glows. To edit an entire layer on the canvas, enable the Transform tool. Select the interested layer from the right and move it by dragging on it and drag outside of its box to rotate it around the cross point. Use the nodes to resize the layer and drag from its borders to skew it. From the tool options, you can also apply perspective or choose liquify to drag pixels. Now, let's see how to work with images. When opening one, the image shows a single background layer representing it. You can enable any brush tool to draw on it. However, this will permanently edit the pixels of the image. Make sure to create a new paint layer above the image to draw on such layer while preserving the original image content. To apply image corrections, click on the plus button to add a new filter layer, choosing the specific adjustment you need and refining its settings while checking the canvas. Consider that the filter layer applies to all the layers below it in the list under the Layers panel. To modify these corrections anytime, right-click on the filter layer and go to Properties. To correct small imperfections from your image, enable the Smart Patch tool and brush over these, adjusting the brush size at the top. With the selection tools, you can delimit specific areas of your canvas so that you can apply filters or make brushes only within such region. You can drop rectangular or elliptical regions by clicking and dragging on the canvas, or drop polygons by dropping each node, or draw freehand. Press Ctrl and Shift and A to remove any selection present. With these selections, you can also cut, copy and paste content from the selected layer using Control or Command along with X, C, and V, with the pasted copy placed as a new layer on your canvas. This operation is useful when importing an image from one canvas into another, using the Transform tool to move and edit the image as you need. To save and retrieve your entire canvas as a document, go to File, Save As, and choose a KRA file format. To render the canvas as an image, choose JPEG or PNG to save any transparency, ensuring that the transparent color option is chosen in the Export dialog. To export vectors, you may select the vector layer from the layer panel and then go to Layer, Import, Export, save vector layer as SVG. Well, now you know how to use Krita, so get out there and give us some digital masterpieces using the Krita drawing tool. Thanks so much for watching our video. Don't forget, for more tips, tricks, and tutorials, be sure to visit our YouTube channel or our website.